the Hall of Famers, and this week Hall of Famer on their GLIAC picks is none other than Mark Bishop, a 1999 graduate of the University of Findlay, went in the Hall of Fame in 2011. And Mark, one of the well-known, there's a 10th on the all-time scoring list with 1,658 points. He holds the record for most threes made in a career with 313. Now, I'll jab him a little bit. He doesn't hold the record for most threes attempted as well, but outstanding shooter for the University of Findlay, was all GLIAC 2 years and was an NAIA All-American, and maybe most known for Oilers fans, hit the game-winning three against Harding College in the NCAA, around in the NAIA tournament. Came off a screen and launched one of his traditional 38 to 40 footers, and it was nothing but net, and the Oilers moved on in that tournament. And now, chance for us to go ahead and look at the picks. And first one up, we have some blood on the line. I guess before we get to that, the Hall of Famers have a lead, 39 to 23. They're 39 and 23. I'm 38 and 24, so one game behind the Hall of Famers right now. And we'll see if Mark can continue that. And the first one up is Wayne State at Grand Valley State. And Mark's going to take the home team. He'll take the Lakers. Wayne State coming off two straight losses, actually three straight losses if you go back to the Findlay game. And I got to believe they're going to be hungry to get a win. I'll take the road team and the Warriors. Walsh then travels to Hillsdale. Walsh is on a roll, and so I'm going to go ahead and take the Chargers, because I got to believe if you're on a roll, you go up and play Hillsdale kind of like we did, and the Chargers will get you. Meanwhile, Mark is going to take the Walsh Cavaliers. So two games right off the top that we're head-to-head on. The rest is pretty much chalk from there. Lake Superior State travels to Northern Michigan. Northern Michigan, two impressive wins last week down at Wayne State and Saginaw Valley, but we'll go ahead and both of us will go with the Lakers, Lake Superior State over Northern Michigan. So Ferris State travels to Saginaw Valley in what should be a bloodbath. The Saginaw Valley, four straight losses. Both of us, a little surprised here that both of us took the Bulldogs, but Mark and I will take Ferris State in that one. Ashland travels to Lake Erie College. Not an easy place to play there in Painesville, but we'll go ahead and both take the Eagles in that one. And in our final matchup, Northwood has to travel all the way to Houghton to take on Michigan Tech. Houghton on a Thursday is almost an automatic victory, and both us, both the Hall of Famers and Mark and I will take Michigan Tech to win that one. We're getting ready for the national anthem, so we're going to go ahead and step aside. Don't go anywhere. When we come up next, we'll have the Oilers and Panthers right here on 88.3 WLFC.
Keats Dugout at 3112 North Main Street in Findlay is happy to support Oiler Athletics on 88.3 WLFC. Keats Dugout provides lunches to go, and the menu features items like breaded and shredded chicken, coney dogs, and more. Keats Dugout can be reached by calling 419-423-7911. That's 419-423-7911. Keats Dugout, a proud underwriter of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC. Kirk Chiropractic and Form Medical and Rehabilitation Center is located at 116 West Lima Avenue in Findlay and is proud to support the Orange and Black on 88.3 WLFC. Kirk Chiropractic provides wellness options to treat back pain. You can reach Kirk Chiropractic at kirkchiro.com. That's Kirk, C-H-I-R-O.com, or by calling 419-425-9798. Kirk Chiropractic, underwriting University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
This is Alex White, and you're listening to Oiler Basketball on 88.3.
Welcome back to Croy. We thought we would go ahead and get the national anthem and everything, but we got an issue with the bucket here at Croy, so something always tends to happen, the net issue, so they're going to go ahead and replace the net, and it'll be interesting if they let teams start to warm up again, but it'll give us an opportunity to go ahead and preview this matchup a little bit. Ohio Dominican comes into the ballgame 10-6, overall 5-5 in the GLIAC, and this is a team that has some impressive wins in conference, coming off a win 87-85 over the Dragons. And when you look at Ohio Dominican, the first thing you notice right away is their toughness. Dan Evans is in his third year as the head coach of the Panthers, and he came from Hillsdale, brought some things that you see accustomed with the Chargers, but maybe brought a little more toughness and certainly some athleticism to the table, and has done a nice job. In just his third year, he has him in position not only to make the GLIAC tournament, which certainly they probably should, but then also to really get a chance to be one of the better seeds, and then in the South as well, just find himself two games out in the South. Findlay leads the South at 6-3, ODU at 5-5. Walsh is in second place at 5-4, but certainly a lot of basketball to be played. You look inside the numbers a little bit. We talked about Ronnie Williams and Hassan Variance. Their point guard is Shamir Wall, who's not getting the start today, coming off an injury at Tiffin. But a dynamic point guard at 5'9". He averages 8 points per game, and the key to their offense really is him getting in the paint and then dishing out to their shooters. Getting the start today is going to be Sam Hickey, a 6'3" freshman from Toledo Whitmer, and he's one of the tops in the conference at 51% from three. Outstanding shooter, and we'll see if he's affected at all by having Wall come off the bench or maybe not even play at all. We'll see about that. They do have a local product on their team, the Panthers. Adam Sitlak is out of Liberty Benton High School and has torched us. Beat it 2 years ago, had a great game as a freshman when ODU beat Findlay here 59-56 in Croy. So there's some local people here. Crowd's starting to file in a little bit. You can tell the students are back. The student section has overflowed into the reserve section a little bit. A few seats remaining over in that visitor side. Behind me, pretty well packed. Not a seat available behind the home stands. So we should have a great atmosphere here in Croy. The Oilers, as we said, coming off their loss to Hillsdale College, are 12-4, 6-3 in the GLIAC. And see if they can get that balanced scoring back. Just the Martise Kimbrough on that starting lineup able to get off for 20 points last time. But other than that, wasn't a whole lot of action. So Assistant Sports Information Director Kyle Nierman is able to get the net change. So we'll go ahead and get the ladder out of here, and we'll see if we can go ahead and get started. Now the teams will come back out of the huddle, and we will go ahead now, it appears, and head to the national anthem. So we'll go ahead, step aside. When we return, we'll get those starting lineups and the tip. This is Oilers Basketball on 88.3 WLFC.
This has been your Oilers Basketball pregame show. When we come back, Jason Granger will have the opening tip-off. You're listening to Oilers Basketball on 88.3 WLFC.
Oilers Athletics on 88.3 WLFC is underwritten in part by KT Equipment Rental. Located at 835 Western Avenue in Findlay, KT Equipment Rental has been your locally owned and operated rental service for over 45 years. KT Equipment Rental is your local dealer for steel outdoor power equipment. They can be reached at 419-422-4549. You can also go online to ktequipmentrental.com. KT Equipment Rental, a proud sponsor of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
Outback Steakhouse is happy to underwrite University of Findlay Sports on 88.3 WLFC. Featuring a menu with blooming onions, steaks, and more, Outback Steakhouse is located at 930 Interstate Drive in Findlay. Carryout service is available as well. Carryout orders can be placed at 419-424-1510 or by using the mobile app on your smartphone. Outback Steakhouse at 930 Interstate Drive in Findlay, just off of US 224. A proud underwriter of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
Oiler Sports on 88.3 WLFC is underwritten in part by Steiner & Granger, located at 141 North Main Street in Bluffton. Steiner & Granger can assist you in a financial strategy for your retirement, from mutual funds to annuities to life insurance. Steiner & Granger can be reached at 419-358-0689 or online at steinerandgranger.com. Securities offered through Sage Point Financial Incorporated, member FINRA, SIPC. Insurance services offered through Steiner & Granger, who is not affiliated with Sage Point Financial Incorporated.
Athletics on 88.3 WLFC is brought to you in part by Blanchard Valley Veterinary Clinic, located at 1930 North Main Street in Findlay. The Blanchard Valley Veterinary Clinic is an animal hospital that provides a range of services for your pet. The Blanchard Valley Veterinary Clinic is open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. till 6 p.m. and on Saturdays from 9 a.m. until 1 p.m. You can call them at 419-422-3292. The Blanchard Valley Veterinary Clinic is a proud supporter of University of Findlay Athletics. Oilers Sports on 88.3 WLFC is a service of Bliss Charters in Fostoria. Bliss Charters provides motor coach services to groups of all sizes. Bliss Charters drivers are trained professionals who exceed standards set by Ohio Department of Transportation standards. You can find Bliss Charters online at www.blisscharters.net. You can also reach Bliss by calling 419-435-7144. Bliss Charters is a proud sponsor of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
This is Dylan Blanc, and you're listening to your home for the Oilers Sports, 88.3 WLFC.
Welcome back to Croy. Dr. Mike Anders with a great rendition of the national anthem. And with that, it's time for starting lineups. First for Ohio Dominican, the point guard today is going to be Ronnie Williams, a 6'3" junior from Columbus Brookhaven High School, averages 13 points per game. The two guard will be Sam Hickey, a 6'3" freshman. He's from Toledo Whitmer High School, averages 11 points per game. The three spot, Adam Sitlak, 6'4" junior from Van Buren, Ohio, and went to Liberty Benton High School, averages 6 points per game. The four spot will be Mike DeLong, a 6'5" junior from Powell, Ohio, Olean Tangi Liberty High School, averages 8 points per game. And the center position, Hassan Variance, 6'6" freshman from Queens, New York, but went to high school his senior year in Columbus, Lyndon McKinley High School, averages 12 points per game, 8 rebounds. ODU is coached by Dan Evans, 10-6 overall, 5-5 in the GLIAC. And now to take a look at the University of Findlay, the point guard is Ricardo Smith, 6'2" senior from Toledo Whitmer High School, averages 6 points per game, pulls down 4 rebounds. The two spot, Martise Kimbrough, 6'1" junior from LCC, averages 18 points per game, pulls down 3 rebounds. The three spot, Elijah Collett, 6'3" junior from Fort Recovery, averages 11 points per game, pulls down 2 rebounds. The four-man, Taryn Sullivan, 6'6" junior from Lima Bath High School. Taryn averages 16 points per game, pulls down 7 rebounds. And the man in the middle of the night, TST, Tyler Stern Tucker, 6'8" senior from Powell, Ohio, Worthington, Kilbourne High School. Tyler averages 9 points per game, pulls down 5 rebounds. The Oilers are coached by Charlie Ernst, his fifth season as the head coach of the Oilers, 118 wins to 44 defeats. Coming to today's ball game, 12-4 overall, 6-3 in the GLIAC. Tonight's officials, John Floyd, Ed Phillips, and Sweet Mo Kincaid in the house here for the guys in stripes. And speaking of that house, Croy is starting to fill up. Just a few seats available now across the way. As the lights are still off, the Panthers will be in their road black jerseys, and the Oilers are going to sport those pretty sharp home white jerseys. Very interested to see how the Oilers come out here. This is a team that had rattled off 7 straight wins before really getting throttled at Hillsdale. And you got to believe they'll have somewhat of a salty attitude here in Troy. At least you hope so. They finish the starting lineups here at Croy. The officials will bring the ball to center court. A reminder, follow us on Twitter, @OilersOnAir is the handle. Another reminder, all home games can be watched on UFTV. Follow them on Twitter as well, @UFTV. You can find them on Time Warner Cable as well or on their YouTube channel. So it'll be Hassan Variance to jump center for ODU. Tyler Stern Tucker for the Oilers. So we'll go ahead and come out of the huddle here. Lights come back on. It'll be John Floyd to throw it up for the guys in stripes. And we're about ready to get things started. Some handshakes for all here. So here comes John Floyd. TST versus Variance. Ball's in the air, and Variance will win the tap. Goes back to DeLong, and then back to Ronnie Williams. He'll take it across the timeline. Williams right side to Variance, top of the key with it. Then sends it over to Hickey. Sam Hickey, 51% from downtown. Sends it out and reverses the basketball. Back into Ronnie Williams. He'll come out. Three-point jumper on the way, but Sitlak, that's off the mark. Rebound tipped around, corralled by Ricardo. Here come the Oilers. Rick, hesitation, driving the lane, throw it up with the right hand, got it. Ricardo Smith goes right at Ronnie Williams. Nothing he could do about it. Oilers take a 2-0 lead, just underway here from Croy. Williams left side, right side, now top of the key to Variance. Variance finds Sitlak, defended by Collick. Sitlak will come around the screen, back to Sam Hickey, send it inside to Variance. He'll go up and in, missed it. Rebound, our ball comes just off the rim. Oilers got away with one there. And here we come back the other way. Taryn, right side, a little stutter step. Now he'll come around the screen. Oh, had an easy one inside. Didn't get it up and under to TST. Got it blocked. No foul called. And back we go the other way. Boy, if Taryn keeps coming, he's got an easy dunk. Top of the key to Variance. Left side and back to Hickey. Hickey come around the screen. Right side, Sitlack. Oilers getting what they want in these first two possessions, just unable to convert. Oilers with a two-zip lead early on. Sitlack, top of the key, turned it down, goes back to Hickey. Hickey with a baseline drive, cut off by Martise, and a traveling violation. Shuffled his feet that time, and a turnover. And Dan Sardo just told Taren, hey, just keep dribbling with that basketball. He's got an easy one. I think Taren knew it. So back we go the other way. Here comes Ricardo Smith. Left-handed dribble, hand back to Martise, and Martise will come out to the front, and then left side and send it inside, and they're going to call an offensive foul. Trying to post up Ricardo Smith. John Floyd will call the offensive foul. It'll be the first on Rick, first team foul on the Oilers. So we got off to a really hot start there, and then the missed layup, and now the turnover on the offensive foul. Here's Ronnie Williams, top of the key, crossover dribble. Picked it up, needs some help, sent it to the corner to Sitlack. Sitlack gets a screen, he'll come around it, dump down the short corner to DeLong. DeLong will throw it up with the left hand, missed it. Offensive foul is going to go against Variance, and really nice position down low that time with Tyler Stern Tucker. So, off the offensive foul, back-to-back offensive fouls, and now it'll be Oiler possession. Right point to Sullivan, top of the key TST. Ricardo falls down. Now he gets back up, gets the basketball. Top of the key Martise comes around the screen, throws up the shot, short, rebound to Variance. And he'll hand it off to Williams. Another good look for Findlay. Williams, left point, now over left side to Sitlack. Picked up his dribble, finds Hickey, and then right side to Ronnie Williams. Williams, baseline drive, whistle, and a foul. Foul on Ricardo Smith. That's going to be the second on Rick. So Trey Smith will check into the ball game, and some early foul trouble for the Oilers. So Ricardo will take a seat. Trey Smith come into the ball game. So this makes things a little bit interesting for the Oilers. Sitlack the inbound. Tried to go to Hickey, not there. Now comes all the way up top, nearly stolen away by Kimbrough. Left side, Williams. Williams, little stutter step, come around the screen, cut off, and back to the top to Variance. 20 on the shot clock. He'll hand back to Williams. Williams around the screen, stutter step into the short corner. DeLong throw it up, got it to go for two. Good offense that time by Williams, and we're all tied up two apiece. Trey Smith with the basketball. Top of the key with it, right side, Elijah. Stutter step, driving the lane, kick out TST. Reverse it. Left side to Trey, back to the top to TST. Now he'll drive in the lane, cut off, kick out Taren. Taren, hesitation, now he'll drive by, right by DeLong, throw it up with the right hand, missed it. And rebound comes to ODU. Boy, there's cold shooting to start this contest. Sitlack pushes the envelope, kick out Hickey, he'll throw it up. Off the mark, rebound kicked around, out of bounds, and it'll go to the Oilers. So Oilers have had a lot of good looks. Easy look inside by Tyler Stern Tucker, no good. Easy look by Taren, no good. And we're all tied up at two, and we get a whistle. And a bloody nose here, or lip, for Martise Kimbrough. So Martise will have to come over and get that worked on. And I'll go ahead and send Cat Singleton in the game. So Cat will come into the ball game. So some early adversity here for Findlay. As Martise is out with a bloody nose, see if we get that stop. Ricardo Smith is on the pine with two fouls, and it's 16:45 to go in the first quarter. We're all tied up at two. Send it left side to Elijah. Elijah will come around the screen, back to Taren. Taren, fancy dribbling. Now he's looking to back down Hickey, get in the paint, throw it up the right hand. It's good. High arcing shot that time, and Taren's got 2 points, and the Oilers lead 4-2. Williams walking across the timeline, find Variance, and hand back to Hickey. Hickey then to DeLong, back to Williams. Williams all alone from downtown. He'll launch it off the mark. Rebound battled for, and comes away to ODU. Send it outside and back in to Variance. They'll go ahead and clear out for him. Variance, whistle, and a blocking foul. They're going to get Tyler Stern Tucker that time. I think if TST falls down, you got something. But he kept on his feet and picked up the foul. So it's the first foul on TST. So it'll be ODU basketball underneath their own 10. Sitlack the inbound. Tried to go inside. Now come to the corner and Williams. Williams still with the basketball. Dribble out of pressure. Top the key. Reverse it. Right side to Sitlak. Sitlak defended by Singleton. Down the post to DeLone. He'll turn, face, throw it up. Got it. Nice move down there on the block. We're all tied up at four. Under 16 to play in the first. Quickly the other way to the Oilers. Top the key, TST. He'll hand back to Cat. Cat then to the baseline to Tyler. Tyler goes up strong. Offensive. No, bucket in the foul. As it looked like they first went ahead and called charge. Changed it to a block. So it's bucket in the foul, and we'll take it. Before we get to that foul shot, we get a media timeout. 15:47 to go in this first quarter. Oilers lead at 6-4. This is Oilers basketball on UFTV and 88.3 WLFC.
Biologistics is proud to support UFTV and the Findlay Media Network. Watch Oilers basketball live on uftv.findlay.edu.
Why do I choose Union Bank? Because they understand that I work hard for my money and deserve a reward, like Everyday Rewards Checking, a checking account that rewards you with a refund on your ATM charges. Plus, you can get paid cash rewards or great interest rate rewards just for using your debit card or paying a bill online, right from your phone or tablet. Stop by the Union Bank today and ask about Everyday Rewards Checking or visit us online, your community bank.
Union Bank.
Member FDIC.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID. UFTV is your university and community TV station.
WLFC. Hello, Oilers. This is Nick Broussas from the Findlay basketball team. You're listening to 88.3.
Welcome back to Croy. And out of the timeout, it'll be Tyler Stern-Tucker to head to the line for opportunity for the old-fashioned three-point play. Martise Kimbrough still over by the trainer trying to fix that bloody nose. So TST will toe the stripe. Foul shot on its way, left it way short. It nearly had his own offensive rebound, and then picked up by Ronnie Williams. Williams back to Shamir Wall, who checked into the ballgame. Wall then will go right side to Williams and back to DeLon and back to Ronnie Williams. 2-3 zone. Ball comes inside. Variance throw it up. Rattles it home for two. And we're all tied up at six. So back we go the other way. TST left side. Hand back to Elijah. Elijah down low. TST turn face. Throw up the shot. Got it. Rattled it in. Back-to-back buckets for TST. 2-point lead for the Oilers. Wall hand off to Williams. Williams is a stutter step. Top of the key. And then reverse it to Sitlak. Sitlak drives in on Elijah. Got away with a huge walk. Back out to Wall. Left point. 15 on the shot clock. Down the baseline to Williams. And there is the traveling violation. And a turnover. So a little token pressure by Samir Wall. Ball will come in to Trey Smith. Send it ahead to Taren. Taren then will take it across the timeline. Martise Kimbrough will come back in. The next dead ball. Trey. Top the key, right side to Singleton. Send it back out top, reverse it over to Sullivan. Taren down low to Cat. Cat looking to go to work. Double team comes, up and under move. Cat throw it up, no, missed it. Airballed it from 2 feet, just shot it too hard. Off the glass, and here comes ODU. Wall behind the back dribble, then over left point to Variance. Sitlak with it now, and then set it down short corner. De Leon looking on Sullivan, needs some help. Kick out, and then reverse it to Wall. Wall lost it out of bounds, and we get a timeout, and Shamir Wall calls a timeout to save the possession. So I believe it's just a 30-second timeout, so we'll go ahead and keep it here. See if we can get an update on some GLIAC scores here shortly. Some big matchups in the GLIAC here today. Martise Kimbrough did check back into the ball game, so that bloody nose is fixed there. Michigan Tech with a 30-28 lead over Northwood, 6:16 to go in that first half. Lake Erie and Ashland just underway from Painesville. And then all the rest are 8 o'clock starts. Wayne State at Grand Valley State, Walsh at Hillsdale. Lake Superior State travels to Marquette to take on Northern Michigan. And then Ferris State at Saginaw Valley. So out of the timeout, it'll be 12 on the shot clock for ODU. Shamir Wall to inbound. Oilers have not been able to get any rhythm here offensively. Still have that two-point lead. See if having Tease back in the lineup helps with that. Wall will send it in to De Leon, and then back up top to Williams. 2-3 zone here for the Oilers. Nearly stolen away by Trey Smith. Six on the shot clock. De Leon kick out Williams. NBA range three on the way. Short. Long rebound picked up by Trey Smith. Quickly ahead to Tease. Step back three coming. In and out. Rebound picked up, but stolen away by Trey Smith. Back out to Tease. Martise in some trouble. Finds TST up and in for two. Great pass by Martise Kimbrough on the Oilers with a four-point advantage at 10-6. Wall nearly got it stolen away again. Goes out of bounds into the scorer's table, and he'll stay here with ODU. Trey Smith making an impact here early with Ricardo Smith with two fouls. Ball across the timeline. Now he'll send it to DeLeon. DeLeon hand back to Ronnie Williams. He'll run him around a screen, driving the lane, kick out Sitlak. Thought about the three. Now he'll hand back to Williams. 13 on the shot clock. Sitlak got away with the wall. Wall comes in. Double team comes, and we should have a jump ball. And we do. It'll go the other way with Findlay. So Cat Singleton picks up the block on variance. So Sam Hickey will check back in before we get to action. Elijah Cogg will come in as well. Taryn Sullivan will take a seat. So the foul trouble with Ricardo Smith will change the rotation here for Coach Charlie Ernst. Elijah will take the basketball across the timeline. And hand back to Singleton at the top. Cat right side to Martise. Martise defended by Sitlak. Comes around a screen. Kick over to Trey. Trey will step into a three-point bomb. That's off the mark. Rebound picked up by the Panthers. Here they come. Shamir Wall quickly the other way. Out of control. Drives all the way in. Cut off by TST. Then back top of the key to Hickey. Hickey come around the screen and back left point. Wide open three that time by Casanova. Off the mark. Strong board by Trey Smith. Trey will send it ahead left side. Now Martise. Oilers with a four-point lead. Martise around the screen. He'll launch a three again. Off the mark. Martise 0-3 in this ballgame. That was a quick one. Panthers back the other way. Wall got it stolen away. Pick from the backside. Trey Smith got it. Trey's got two steals. Right side to Elijah. Sent it down inside to TST. Turn face. Throw up the shot. Got it. Tyler Stern Tucker. He's got 6 points, and the Oilers have a six-point lead at 12-6. So Wall now dribble right side. Hand off to Sitlak. Sitlak. Looking up Elijah, then over to Hickey. Hickey thought about the three. Behind the back dribble. Now send it to the baseline. To Wall. Wall come around the screen. Nobody picks him up. Elbow jumper way short. Rebound picked up by Tyler Stern Tucker. Send it ahead to Martise. Martise will drive in. Throw up the shot. Can't get it, but he's fouled. Good strong drive by Martise. And we'll see if he can get his rhythm shooting-wise at the line, where Martise is 94% foul shooter. So I have a couple substitutions here. Terrence Solomon will check in the ballgame. AO as well, Aaron Oberheiser. First foul shot coming for Tease. That one rattles home. So Sullivan and Oberheiser check into the game. Trey Smith will take a seat. TST will take a seat. Variance will check out. And Michael Simon, a 6'6" sophomore from Hillier-Davidson High School, he'll check in. Oilers with their largest lead at 7 can make it 8 here with the foul shot from Tease. Foul shot on its way, and that's also good. So 14-6 is the score. 12 minutes to go here in this first half. Next whistle will bring us to that media timeout. Wall, right side, picked up his dribble. Needs some help. Sends it all the way up top. Nearly got it stolen away, and Oberheiser picks it up. Aaron. Driving in the lane, needs some help. Kick out the colleague, Elijah from downtown, short. Boy, that would have been a big one there. Rebounded away by Wall. Shamir Wall, hesitation, driving the lane, throw it to the left hand, got it. Boy, he is quick, and Oilers had a chance to go up 11 there, and just like that, now it's back down to 6. Martise, come around the screen, dumped down low to AO, then he got it stripped off his knee and sent it the other way. Good idea that time, but a turnover, and that will send us to a media timeout. 14-8 is the score. Oilers out in front. This is Oilers basketball on UFTV and 88.3 WLFC.
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it. It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Biologistics is proud to support UFTV and the Findlay Media Network. Watch Oiler basketball live on uftv.findlay.edu.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID. UFTV is your university and community TV station.
And you're listening to Oiler basketball on 88.3.
Welcome back to Croy. Jason Granger here with you. 14-8 is the lead. Oilers down in front, but off the turnover be ODU basketball. Findlay shooting 43%. High Dominican just 31%. Tyler Stern Tucker has 8 points, leads all scorers. So Casanova, quite the last name there. We'll pass it into Ronnie Williams. He'll take it across the timeline. Now dribble right side. Start the offense there. Nearly got it stolen away to Casanova. Defended by Solomon. Back to Williams. Then left side Hickey. Hickey went way downtown. That's off the mark. Rebound tipped around up and in for two. Oilers struggled on the boards against Hillsdale and struggled there. Just a four-point lead now for Findlay. Right side to Elijah. He'll come around a screen. Drive and a step back, thought about the three, then gets to kick it out. Whistle. Foul's going to go on Sam Hickey. That was Michael Simon and knocked in the offensive rebound there for ODU. Trey Smith will come into the ball game. Cat will take a seat. Shamir Wall will also check in. Hickey will come out. He's got two fouls. So now we have a conversation between the officials here. Shamir Wall never checked in, so now he'll go ahead and check in. So Martise will inbound underneath his own 10. Ball comes to the baseline to Taren. Reverse it top of the key to Elijah. Elijah around the screen. Now drive into the lane. In some trouble. Lost it out of bounds. He'll stay right here with the Oilers. Second opportunity for Findlay with 24 on the shot clock. Trying to go inside to Taren. Not there. Atop of the key, Trey Smith. He'll step into a three-point jumper off the back iron. Oilers really struggling to shoot the basketball. Sending ahead to Williams. Williams right side, top of the key to Simon. Simon then back to Williams. He'll throw it up short. Rebound picked up by Oberheis. Nearly traveled the basketball. Finds Trey Smith. Quickly ahead to Elijah, left side. Elijah will come around the screen, top of the key, driving the lane. Reverse pivot, needs some help. Cross-court pass to Trey. Turned down to three. Now he'll drive in the lane. Stop, throw it up with the right hand, but he traveled with the basketball. Ball went down, unfortunately. Traveling violation and confidence a little bit of a problem right now for the Oilers. Still have a four-point lead at 14-10. 10:25 to go in this first half. Get a feeling the first team to get hot is going to have quite the advantage. Wall, left side, comes around to Simon screen. Now he'll drive all the way in. He got a block, but they're going to say a foul. Foul's going to go against Taren Sullivan. Tough call on Taren. Foul starting to pile up here. Be the first foul on Taren. 14th foul on the Oilers. Smart Wall stepped to the line, two shots. First foul shot is way short, nearly airballed it. Oberheiser come out of the ball game. TST will check in. Second foul shot coming for Wall. Lefty able to knock that one in and then lead down to three. Oilers have been caught on 14 since the 15-minute mark. Kimbrough at the top. Sends it right point to TST. Thought about the three. Top of the key, Taren. Reverse it left side to Martise, top of the key, Kalik. Elijah will drive all the way in, up and under for two. Showed the ball with the left hand, came back to the right, and that gets the Oilers off the schneid and a five-point lead. Wow, Tried to drive in the lane, can't do it. Has to double back out of it, almost fell down. Top to Key Casanova, hand back to Williams. Wide open three by Williams, airballed it. Rebound comes to Trey Smith. Trey looking ahead, finds Elijah. Elijah with a baseline drive. Up 6 foot, can't get it. Tip back, no good. Ball still on the floor. TST picks it up. A lot of contact, no call. Elijah with another board. Needs some help. Whistle and a travel. So Oilers good hustle that time, and I'm not sure what the call was. As I thought TST got fouled, but no call. So come back the other way here. Wall now will start things left side. Trey Smith defending him, crossover dribble, trying to go in, comes around a screen. And back top of the key, Simon Hill launches from way downtown. That's off the mark. Rebound kicked around and corralled by Elijah Collick. Martise now, top of the key, trying to get Martise in rhythm. Left side, left point to Sullivan. Sullivan around the screen, hesitation, dumped down underneath. TST all alone, easy one. Great pass by Tyler Stern Tucker. And Oilers now up by 7, 18-11. Under 9 minutes to play in this first half. Williams comes around a Casanova screen. Little hesitation, then to Simon. Left side, Sitlak. Sitlak thought about the shot. Back down the corner to Simon. Sitlak, top of the key. He'll drive all the way around. I got it swatted by Taryn Sullivan. He grabs the board as well. Now Taryn will lead the break. Taryn at 6'7". Throw it right side. Elijah need it. Can't get it. Offensive rebound, TST. Back to Taryn. Taryn with the basketball. He'll throw it up with the right hand and got it. Oilers 20-11 lead. A 9-point lead is their largest. And they're just doing it with the hustle. Hadn't been great shooting, but Findlay out hustling ODU now. Left side, Sitlak. Come around to Simon's screen. Pick it up back to Simon. Simon cross-court past the wall. Wall on the baseline. Drive on in. Throw it up. Lost it. Went off his knee. Out of bounds. And it'll be Oilers basketball. So we get substitutions here for Coach Dan Evans. Variance will check back in. Also Sam Hickey. And DeLong. So the Oilers with the bucket here can take a double-digit lead here with 8 minutes to go in the half. So Martise will walk it across the timeline. Send it right point to TST. Tyler turns face and then hand back to Elijah. Elijah top of the key, reverse it to Martise. Trying to go inside, can't do it. Martise step back, jumper on the way. Got it. Hit it from deep. Now they're going to say he had a foot on the line, and the Oilers now lead by 11, 22-11. Right side with the basketball is Sitlak. Ronnie Williams got away with a walk. Kick out to Hickey. Hickey top of the key, whistle, and a foul. Offensive foul, I believe. Or would they call it a travel? Let's wait and see. And the foul is going to go on ODU. Moving screen. It was not on Hickey, and that will send us to our media timeout. Oilers lead it 22-11. This is Findlay Basketball on UFTV and 88.3 WLFC.
Looks like it's done.
Don't let salmonella get funky with your chicken. On average, 1 in 6 Americans will get a foodborne illness this year. You can't see these microbes, but they might be there. So learn the right temperature to cook each type of meat. Keep your family safe at foodsafety.gov.
Why do I choose Union Bank? Because they understand that I work hard for my money and deserve a reward, like Everyday Rewards Checking, a checking account that rewards you with a refund on your ATM charges. Plus, you can get paid cash rewards or great interest rate rewards just for using your debit card or paying a bill online, right from your phone or tablet. Stop by the Union Bank today and ask about Everyday Rewards Checking or visit us online, your community bank.
Union Bank.
Member FDIC.
UFTV is your university and community TV station.
Just 5-19 shooting. Let's hope that continues. Tyler Stern Tucker leads away, 10 points, 5 rebounds for Findlay. So out of the timeout will be Trey Smith, Kat Singleton, Martise Kimbrough, Taryn Sullivan, and Tyler Stern Tucker. So Oilers with a big opportunity here, up 11 and possession of the basketball. So here comes Martise. He'll dribble right side, hand back to Kat. Left point to Taryn. Taryn will put it on the floor. Top of the key with it. No one picks him up. NBA range three is good. Variance doesn't come out and guard him, and Taryn is more confident the farther you take him out. And the Oilers with their biggest lead at 14. Ronnie Williams, right side, top of the key to De Leon, over to Wall, Wall around the screen, then over to Hickey. Right side now, Williams. Williams come around a variance screen, dumped down underneath the variance, throw up the shot is good. Strong move by a freshman that time to stop the bleeding for ODU, and the lead is 12. Left point with the basketball is Taren. Taren at the top, stutter step, hand back to Martise. NBA range three, can we get back to back? No, we can't. Rebound, kicked around, still on the floor, and Wall picks it up. Shamir Wall, drive the lane, kick out Hickey. Hickey from downtown, got it. Sam Hickey in rhythm, and just like that, it's a 5-0 run back the other way. 9-point advantage for Findlay. Top of the key, Trey Smith. Reverse the basketball to no one in particular, out of bounds. 25-16 is the score. Oilers down in front, and an unforced turnover that time. So we got a 5-0 run right now by ODU. Oilers need to stop. Wall, start the offense to De Leon at the top of the key. He'll put it on the floor. Right-handed dribble, hand back to Wall. Wall come out of the screen, trying to find Hickey, not there. Right side, Sitlak, he'll launch it from downtown. That's off the mark. Strong rebound by Singleton, and Cat will lead the break. Cat, top of the key, right side, almost got it picked away. Wall knocks it out of bounds. He'll stay right here with the Oilers. Oilers sloppy with the basketball here. So 25 on the shot clock, 6:11 on the game clock. Oilers up 9, need a bucket. Ball come out by the volleyball line to Martise. Martise call the set, get a screen, and top the key to Taren. Reverse it left side to Trey. They don't guard him. He'll take the three. That's off the mark. Air ball that time. Picked up by ODU. Here's Sam Hickey. He'll drive in the lane. Layup is good. 7-0 run now by Ohio Dominican. Trey Smith, behind the back dribble, top of the key, TST. Hand back to Martise. Double team comes. Now Martise in the lane. Up and under move is good. Big bucket there by Martise Kimbrough, needed it. Stops that 7-0 run by Ohio Dominican. 27-18 is the lead for the Oilers. 5:30 to go in the first half. Variance, top of the key, right side to Hickey. He'll come around that variance screen. Stop at the foul line, throw up the shot off the mark. Long rebound comes to Martise Kimbrough. Martise at the top. Stutter step. Thought about it. Now he'll drive in the lane. Kick out. Taren from downtown. Off the mark. Too close. Rebound to Sam Hickey. Pace is picked up. Wall quickly driving the lane, and he got fouled. Trey Smith picks up the foul. That'll be Trey's first foul. 15th foul on the Oilers. So Smith will come out. Elijah will come in. The ball will inbound, sideline out of bounds. Ball will come in to Hickey. He'll run him off the screen. Baseline jumper is good, and that guy can shoot. Toledo Whitmer High School. 7-point lead for the Oilers at 27-20. Top of the key is Taren Sullivan. Taren put on the floor. Now drive all the way in and slam it home with the right hand. Nobody picked him up, and an easy one for Taren Sullivan. 9-point advantage. Right side to hit the Sitlak. Come around the screen. Almost walked with it. Out to the volleyball line. And left side to Wall. Wall's a fancy dribbling. Gets to the elbow. Thought about the shot. Now looking to go back inside to Variance. And does. Variance down on the block. Working on Singleton. Nearly got it stolen away. Goes out of bounds. And it will go to the Oilers. Great defense by Kat Singleton to force the turnover right into the student section. So Oilers with an opportunity. Had to lead as big as, I believe, 13 in this contest. Chance to get it back up to that, or up back up to double digits. Top key to TST, left side to Sullivan. Send it down low to Cat. Cat looking to go strong. Up and over. Hickey can't get it to go. Just a little hard. Nothing Sam Hickey could do about that. Need to go back to that. Back we go the other way. Left side to Sitlak. Baseline drive. Cut off by Cat. Now he'll dribble back out of it. Reverse it. Right side now to Wall. Wall with a drive. Kick to De Leon. De Leon working back out to Hickey. Hickey with the drive. Got in some trouble there and missed the shot, but he'll go to the line to take two. So two shots at the foul line now for Sam Hickey. But before we get to that, we'll get to our last media timeout. 29-20 is the score. Oilers out in front. 3:47 to go in the first half. This is Oilers basketball on 88.3 WLFC.
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
Or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it. It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID.
Biologistics is proud to support UFTV and the Findlay Media Network. Watch Oiler basketball live on uftv.findlay.edu.
UFTV is your university and community TV station.
Basketball 88.3.
Welcome back to Croy. Oilers out in front by 9, 29-20. Tyler Stern-Tucker leads the way. He's got 9. Taren has 9 points. Also a rebound and an assist. Martise Kimbrough with 6. Leading scorer for Ohio Dominican is Sam Hickey with 7. And he'll be at the line to shoot 2. So Sam Hickey, a freshman from Toledo Whitmer High School, is right up I-75. Outstanding shooter. 52% from 3 is his average on the year. First foul shot is good. Second foul shot coming for Hickey. We should mention he's got 2 fouls. Let's see if the Oilers go back down the block on his matchup. Second foul shot good. So lead back down to 7. 29-22, 3:45 to go in this first half. Right side to Singleton. Sent it down the baseline to TST. He thought about the 3. Now put it on the floor. Drive into the paint. Kick out Cat. Cat will launch it from downtown. Off the back iron. Really a flat shot that time. And Oilers cannot buy a 3. Waugh picks up his dribble, sends it into Variance. Variance will throw it up, and it's blocked. And they're going to call a blocking foul on Elijah Collett. So now they're going to see if it's a goaltend. So now Mo Kincaid coming over to talk about it, and it was an easy block by Tyler Stern-Tucker. So the call was a charge going against Elijah. And so I'm not sure what the conversation. Now we're going to bring in our other official. Right now we got John Flo and Mo Kincaid. Ed Phillips is going to come on in now. He'll send the team to the bench. All officials right now reading their lips. No official saw it. That's pretty easy to determine. So fouls 22 block. We're going to be shoot 2. And the right call is made. So the Oilers have really struggled here offensively. The good news out of it is ODU struggled even more, but they're starting to get hot here. So now Variance will come to line. Two shots coming for the freshman. Impressive defensive team for ODU. Oilers really have some opportunities inside. It's just not their makeup with Alex White out with injury. The points in the paint, tough to come by. Really rely on their jump shots, and it's just not going in. So Variance. Go ahead and take 2 foul shots. The foul went on Elijah. It's his first, team 7th. First foul shot hard off the black iron. So second one coming here for the Oilers. Or for the Panthers, rather. A couple dribbles here for Hassan Variance. Foul shot on the way, and he left that short. Missed both of them. Rebound by TST. He'll go ahead and just take it up the floor. To Tyler, top of key, hand back to Trey. Right side now to Elijah. Elijah gets a screen at the top, comes all the way up top, right side. To Martise. Martise looking to go inside. Not there. Now baseline drive by Tease. He'll throw up the shot quick. Whistle and an offensive foul. Call the foul on Martise and really defending the Oilers hard. And the Oilers are frustrated. And the answer to this pressure outside is to get somebody to post up. Shamir Wall will go left side. Top of the key, Sitlak. Sitlak inside to Variance. Been in the paint forever. He'll throw it up the right hand. Got it. And Charlie Ernst wants a timeout. He's less than thrilled. 29-24. 2:50 to go in this first half. We'll send it back to studio. This is Oiler Basketball, 88.3 WLFC.
Keats Dugout at 3112 North Main Street in Findlay is happy.
Why do I choose Union Bank? Convenience. At work, home, or out and about. I can check my balance from my smartphone, laptop, or tablet, and even deposit a check. I'll find convenient locations all across the region with a staff who cares from my community and a great network of ATMs, so there's always one close by. Visit theubank.com and see just how convenient your community bank is for you. Thank you, Omar. Union Bank. Member FDIC.
Welcome back to Croy. Oilers struggling in this one, but still lead by 5, 25-24. Both teams struggling to shoot the basketball. Oiler possession out of the Charlie Ernst timeout. Here's Martise. Go right side, TST. Thought about the three. Cross-court pass to Cat. Now over to Martise. Cross-court to Trey Smith. Top of the key to Singleton. 15 on the shot clock. Cott will come around the screen. Now he has Variance on him. Driving the lane. Lost possession. Kick out Trey. Trey from downtown. Airballed it. Missed everything. Oilers can't throw it in the ocean here. Sam Hickey reverses the basketball. Go back to Shamir Wall. Wall will start things right side. Go to DeLeon, top of the key, trying to go inside and does the Variance. Double team comes, stripped away, stolen away by Trey. With tons of contact, and finally, we get a call. It's going to go against Adam Sitlak. It'll be the sixth team foul on ODU. So Trey Smith really struggling to shoot the ball, but he's been a beast on the defense. So let's see if we can get a bucket here. I like Cat Singleton down on the block. See if they go back down to him. Trey struggling to get across the timeline. Does. He's out of control. Drive all the way in. Layup no good. Rebound picked up by Sam Hickey. Hickey driving the lane. He got it stolen away. Goes out of bounds. Off of Martise, they say, and he'll stay with the Panthers. So this has been an ugly first half, really both ways. And you look at the Oilers and their opportunities. Poor shooting. Panthers not holding on the basketball. So both coaches are going to have plenty to talk about at the half. Ball come in to De Leon. Top of the key to Sitlak. Feed the post inside to Variance. Nearly got it stolen away and did. Trey Smith picks it up. Need to be under control. Send ahead to Elijah. Back to Martise. Martise from downtown. Got it. Stepped right into that one. Oilers now up by 8. 32-24. Need a defensive stop. Shamir Wall driving the lane, kick out. Sam Hickey wide open. Nobody in the same area code, and he missed it somehow. Rebound comes to Martise. He wants to race it up. Martise, little Euro step, up and in for two, and Martise Kimber on his own 5-0 run. Dan Evans has seen enough. Not going to call a timeout, but wants to slow it down, and Oilers up 10. 34-24, minute 20 to go here in the first half. Wall around the screen, got away with a huge carry into the lane. Needs some help, back out the Variance. Right side to Hickey. Hickey will send it inside to Variance, working against TST. Double team comes and goes into Wall. Wall got swatted from the backside, picked up by Elijah. And here comes Findlay. 4-on-5 break. Elijah, crossover dribble, driving the lane. Stop. Needs some help. Kick out to Cat. Back over to Elijah, right side. Isaac can't get it. Man, he could have checked the win in the building on that one. Not able to get it to go down. All tied up at 10. ODU with the basketball. Left side with it. The Oilers will get another possession. Hickey, top of the key. Ball comes into Variance. Poor pass. Stolen away by TST, and we get a foul. And that'll be the 17th foul on ODU. Variance picks up his second on a cheapie. So that'll send TST to the line for one plus the bonus. You know, Elijah Collins, one of these shooters, you're surprised when he misses one. Just like Mark Bishop was. Nate Hyde, some of the great shooters we've had here. I mean, he had all day to knock that one in and did everything but go in. So TST, big foul shot here. Just one. If he makes it, he'll get another one. Foul shot coming, and that one rattles home. So Oiler lead is 11. 35 seconds to go in the first half, so there'll be a chance at another possession for the Oilers here if they get a stop. Second foul shot coming. Left that one short. Rebound comes to ODU. So Shamir Wall, go ahead and walk it up the timeline. Just barely gets it across. Now we'll stand with the basketball on the right side. Hand back to Hickey. Hickey to De Leon at the top of the key. De Leon will go right side, back to Wall. Wall around some screens there. Fancy dribbling. Stutter step, nearly got it stolen away. Ball on the floor, picked up by Wall. He'll drive back in, and he's out of bounds. So just out of control that time by Shamir Wall. And credit Trey Smith. Trey hasn't been able to knock down many shots, but his defense has been great with the absence of Ricardo Smith, who's out with foul trouble. So 9 seconds to go. Oilers now will have an opportunity. Full court pressure by Adam Sitlak. Ball comes into Martise. 7 seconds, 6 seconds as they get across the timeline. Martise is going to line him up. 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Step back three on the way. Count it. Martise Kimbrough knocks it down from Lima. And the Oilers lead 38-24. This is Oilers basketball on 88.3 WLFC.
Kirk.
It's not always easy being a dad.
Do you have panda asthma too? Does that run in the family?
This is the home of the most priceless kung fu artifacts.
But when you make an effort...
Dad, we're not supposed to touch anything.
Oh, sorry.
Go along, son.
It's always worth it.
Whoa, master!
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
I am gonna get you. I'm gonna get you.
Call 877-4DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov to learn more.
At Cakes for Heaven's Sake, come in for a sweet escape from your busy life. Cakes for Heaven's Sake, where we specialize in custom cakes for all occasions, mouthwatering cupcakes, cookies, candies, and more. We can also provide the do-it-yourself baker with the supplies to make their own sweet creation. Stop by today for a ready-made sweet treat or to place an order for your special occasion. When you order from Cakes for Heaven's Sake, your order is designed with the help of our staff with you and your special occasion in mind. Your ideas designed for your personality, budget, and taste. Then it's baked to order for your special day. We are a locally owned and family operated business. We are here to give inspiration to your special occasion, whether for one, hundreds, or thousands. Cakes for Heaven's Sake, where the cakes speak for themselves. 1201 North Main Street, Findlay, across the street from the University of Findlay Kaler Center.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID.
Welcome to the Oiler Basketball Halftime Show on 88.3 WLFC. Analysis and stats from the first half, scores from around the GLIAC, and a look at what's happening across Oiler Nation. Let's head back out to Press Row, and the voice of the Oilers, Jason Granger.
Thank you, Ron, and welcome back to Croy. Oilers with a great run. It was 29-24 with about 3 minutes to go in that first half, and the Oilers finish the half on a 9-0 run and lead 38-24. And what a crazy shot by Martise Kimbrough. A step back from way downtown to knock in that three. And it was a tough first half. Ricardo Smith picked up two quickies within the first 3 minutes of the first half. Trey Smith had to run this point guard really the entire first half. Did a fine job, struggled shooting, but able to pick up a number of steals. And no bigger than that steal right at the end of the half that allowed Martise to get that big shot at the end of the half to knock it in. Oilers struggled shooting the ball, but able to work through defensively. A strong defensive effort. Sam Hickey has been able to do a little bit for ODU. He has 9 points, but other than that, Oilers did a nice job keeping Ronnie Williams in check, as well as Hassan Variance. He just has 6 points. So halftime score, 38-24 in favor of the Oilers. We'll send it back to the studio, and when we return, we'll have the stats. This is Oilers Basketball on UFTV and 88.3 WLC.
Athletics on 88.3 WLFC is brought to you in part by Blanchard Valley Veterinary Clinic, located at 1930 North Main Street in Findlay. The Blanchard Valley Veterinary Clinic is an animal hospital that provides a range of services for your pet. The Blanchard Valley Veterinary Clinic is open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. till 6 p.m. and on Saturdays from 9 a.m. until 1 p.m. You can call them at 419-422-3292. The Blanchard Valley Veterinary Clinic is a proud supporter of University of Findlay Athletics. Oilers Sports on 88.3 WLFC is a service of Bliss Charters in Fostoria. Bliss Charters provides motor coach services to groups of all sizes. Bliss Charters drivers are trained professionals who exceed standards set by Ohio Department of Transportation standards. You can find Bliss Charters online at www.blisscharters.net. You can also reach Bliss by calling 419-435-7144. Bliss Charters is a proud sponsor of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
University of Findlay Sports is brought to you on 88.3 WLFC in part by City Barbecue on Flag City Drive in Findlay. City Barbecue Catering can cook for groups of all sizes and can handle your special requests. You can find City Barbecue at 15033 Flag City Drive in front of Menards. You can reach them by calling 419-422-200. Or find them online at citybarbecue.com. City Barbecue, a proud supporter of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC. Dick's Auto Supply is a proud supporter of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC. Dick's Auto Supply can be found in two locations, in Findlay at 349 Midland Avenue and in Fostoria at 601 Plaza Drive. Dick's Auto Supply provides a selection of parts and accessories for your vehicle. You can reach Dick's Auto Supply by calling 800-682-1419 or online at dicksautosupplyinc.com. Dick's Auto Supply, supporting University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
We're at halftime with the Oilers leading Ohio Dominican 38-24. This is Ron Kanoff in the 88.3 WLFC studios with more of your Oiler basketball halftime report. Earlier tonight, it was the leading Oilers falling to Ohio Dominican 82-51. Findlay was led by Krista Putoff's 10 points, 5 boards. Ladies fall to 8-9 overall and 2-7 in the conference. Taking a look at men's games in progress. 14.5 to go in the first half. Ashton leads at Lake Erie, 11-7. 14 minutes to go, second half. Northwood and Michigan Tech all tied up at 48. 16 minutes ago, first half, Grand Valley State currently leads Wayne State, 10-2. 13 minutes ago, first half, Lake Superior State over Northern Michigan, 12-11. 10.5 to go, first half, Hillsdale leading Walsh, 19-15. And midway through the first half, Saginaw Valley losing right now to Ferris State, 7-6. Taking a look at your 419 area forecast, calling for mostly cloudy skies through the evening with showers starting after midnight. We'll have a low tonight at 37. Friday, it'll be mostly cloudy with rain throughout the day. Our high will top out at 52. We'll have a low of 45. And the weekend starts off with more of the same, plenty of clouds and plenty of rain. The high will be 58. We'll have a low of 46. Currently in the 419 area, we have overcast skies and 39 degrees. After a short break, we'll get you back out to the Croy Center, where Jason will have analysis and stats of all the action from the first half. Findlay leads Ohio Dominican 38-24. You're listening to the Oiler Basketball Halftime Report on 88.3 WLFC.
Oiler Athletics is brought to you in part by Domino's Pizza at 224 North Main Street in Findlay. You can find Domino's Pizza online at www.ohiodominoes.com, or you can call using the Domino's mobile app on your smartphone. Domino's Pizza in Findlay can also be reached by calling 419-423-3333. Again, you can reach Domino's at 419-423-3333. Domino's Pizza is a proud supporter of Oilers Sports on 88.3 WLFC. Drury Inn and Suites is a supporter of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC. Drury Inn and Suites is located at 820 Trenton Avenue, Route 224 West in Findlay. Guest amenities include two-room suites and an indoor and outdoor pool. You can reach Drury Inn and Suites online at druryhotels.com, or you can contact them by calling the Findlay location at 419-422-9700. Drury Inn & Suites in Findlay is a proud underwriter of University of Findlay Sports on 88.3 WLFC.
University of Findlay Athletics is sustained on 88.3 WLFC by Frickers. Frickers is located at exit 157 off of Interstate 75 in Findlay, featuring wings, burgers, and sports on every TV. You can contact Frickers by calling 419-423-9464. Frickers is also on the web at frickers.com. Sprickers just off of I-75 and State Route 12, a proud underwriter of University of Findlay Sports on 88.3 WLFC.
Jimmy John's in Findlay serves subs baked on bread baked in-house every day. Serving single sandwiches and party platters, Jimmy John's is located at 536 Trenton Avenue in Findlay. If you don't want to get off the couch, you can also order online at www.jimmyjohns.com or through the Jimmy John's mobile app for your smartphone. Jimmy John's, proudly underwriting University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
This is Dylan Blanc, and you're listening to your home for the Oilers Sports, 88.3 WLFC.
Welcome back to Croy. Jason Granger here with you. Thanks to Ron Knopf, now I'm having to answer birthday questions on Press Row, but that's another topic for another day. And back, opportunity for us to look at the stats. Let's start with Ohio Dominican. They're led by Sam Hickey, 3 of 7 from the floor, 1 of 4 from three-point range, 2 of 2 from the foul line, 9 points, 7 rebounds. Mike DeLeon, 2 of 3 from the floor, 4 points, 4 rebounds. Hassan Variance, 3 of 5 from the floor, 6 points, 4 rebounds, and 1 block. Ronnie Williams, leading scorer on this basketball team, came in averaging 13 points per game. He's held scoreless, 0-4 from the floor, 0-3 from downtown. Does have a rebound and 2 assists. Adam Sitlak, the local product from Van Buren, has not scored either. 0-3 from the floor, no points and a rebound. Shamir Waugh, 16 minutes off the bench, 3 points, 2 rebounds. Ben Casanova, 1-2 from the floor, 2 points, 2 rebounds. And then Michael Simon played 4 minutes. Did not score. As a team, ODU goes 10 of 28 for 36%. 1 of 11 from downtown, that's 9%. And then 3 of 6 from the foul line for 50%. For the Oilers, led by Martise Kimbrough, got hot at the end of the half. 5 of 9 from the floor, 2 of 6 from three-point range, 2 of 2 from the foul line, 14 points. Terrence Sullivan, 4 of 6 from the floor, 1 of 2 from downtown, 9 points, 1 rebound, 1 assist, and a block. Tyler Stern-Tucker played 18 minutes in the first half. 5 of 7 from the floor. 11 points, 6 rebounds, and a steal. Ricardo Smith made the first bucket of the ballgame, then picked up 2 fouls. That's 2 points and a rebound. Elijah Collick, 1 of 5 from the floor, 0 of 3 from downtown, 2 points, 3 assists, 3 rebounds. Played 17 minutes. Off the bench, Kat Singleton played 13 minutes and not score. Does have 2 blocks. Trey Smith, 15 minutes for Trey due to the foul trouble for Ricardo. 0 of 5 from the floor, but has 3 rebounds and 4 steals. Aaron Overhager played 2 minutes and not score, has a rebound. Oilers go 16 of 36, that's 44%. Just 3 of 6 from downtown for 19%, and then 3 of 5 from the foul line for 60%. Points in the paint all tied up at 14. Points off turnovers, 16 to 5 in favor of the Oilers. Second chance points, ODU has that 4 to 2. Fast break points, 9 to 7 in favor of Findlay. And then bench points, 5 zip in favor of ODU. Score was tied 3 times. Lead never changed. Oilers have led it throughout. Biggest lead by the Oilers is 14. That came right at the end of the half after Martise able to knock down that long-range bomb. Findlay has led almost the majority, 18 minutes and 24 seconds. Game's been tied for a minute and 36 seconds. Halftime score, Oilers lead at 38-24. We'll go ahead and send it back to the studio. You're listening to Oilers Basketball on 88.3 WLFC.
Keats Dugout at 3112 North Main Street in Findlay is happy to support Oiler Athletics on 88.3 WLFC. Keats Dugout provides lunches to go, and the menu features items like breaded and shredded chicken, coney dogs, and more. Keats Dugout can be reached by calling 419-423-7911. That's 419-423-7911. Keats Dugout, a proud underwriter of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC. Kirk Chiropractic and Form Medical and Rehabilitation Center is located at 116 West Lima Avenue in Findlay and is proud to support the Orange and Black on 88.3 WLFC. Kirk Chiropractic provides wellness options to treat back pain. You can reach Kirk Chiropractic at kirkchiro.com. That's Kirk, C-H-I-R-O.com, or by calling 419-425-9798. Kirk Chiropractic, underwriting University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
Oiler Athletics on 88.3 WLFC is underwritten in part by KT Equipment Rental. Located at 835 Western Avenue in Findlay, KT Equipment Rental has been your locally owned and operated rental service for over 45 years. KT Equipment Rental is your local dealer for steel outdoor power equipment. They can be reached at 419-422-4549. You can also go online to ktequipmentrental.com. KT Equipment Rental, a proud sponsor of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
Outback Steakhouse is happy to underwrite University of Findlay Sports on 88.3 WLFC. Featuring a menu with blooming onions, steaks, and more, Outback Steakhouse is located at 930 Interstate Drive in Findlay. Carryout service is available as well. Carryout orders can be placed at 419-424-1510 or by using the mobile app on your smartphone. Outback Steakhouse at 930 Interstate Drive in Findlay, just off of US 224. A proud underwriter of University of Findlay Athletics on 88.3 WLFC.
Hello, Oilers. This is Nick Broussas from the Findlay basketball team. You're listening to 88.3.
Welcome back to Croy. Jason Granger here with you. Oilers out in front, 38-24, and getting ready to get things started here in the second half. Oilers a little late to come out of the halftime break, so getting some quick shots up. As we mentioned, Martise Kimbrough with 14 points leads the way for the Oilers on 5-9 shooting. Tyler Stern-Tucker has been impressive as well with 11, and then Terrence Sullivan. And Terrence Sullivan with 9 points. So we'll go ahead and get things started. It'll be a high Dominican basketball, I believe. Well, wait and see. Now they get Findlay basketball, actually, as they're going to change things with the scores table. And now they'll change it again. It'll be ODU basketball. So now we get it right. So Ricardo Smith back on the floor after getting the two timeouts. Should be well rested, just playing 2 minutes. So De Leon will inbound, sends it in to Ronnie Williams. And the Oilers will show 1-3-1 zone. Williams in some trouble. Cross-court pass to De Leon, and De Leon back to Williams. Send it to the corner. Sitlak wide open for three, and he nailed it. Well, that'll get you out of the zone real quick. Down to 11-point lead. Top of the key, Sullivan. Left side to Martise. Martise comes around the screen. De Leon on him. Send it down to the post to Terrence Sullivan. Terrence, turn face, looking to attack. Kick out Martise. NBA range three on the way. Way off the mark. Sitlak grabs the rebound. ODU wants to run. Send it ahead to Williams. Williams eyes up Ricardo Smith. Now they'll send it down low to Variance. Variance back out to Ronnie Williams. He'll launch from downtown. It's good. 6-0 run to start the half here for ODU, and this lead is down to 8. Sullivan will look over De Leon, trying to go inside, not there. Top the key to Ricardo. Ricardo now put it on the floor, crossover dribble, driving the lane, throw it up with the right hand, missed it, airballed everything. Sam Hickey picks up the rebound, and ODU looking to build on this 6-0 run. Top the key to Ronnie Williams. Send it down the baseline to Sitlak. He'll come around the screen, walk with the basketball, but no call. Into the elbow to Variance. Variance in some trouble. He walked. No call. Down to De Leon. De Leon. Back and down Martise. Pass comes underneath and blocked away by TST. Oilers get a stop. See if that means offense. Martise, right side, eyeing up De Leon. Lost the basketball. Needs help. Goes right side to Colic. Now gets the ball back top of the key. Kimbrough with it. Sends it left point to Ricardo. They'll start the offense. 14 on the shot clock. Ricardo picks up his dribble. Send it down the baseline. Sullivan will launch a shot, and that gets the Oilers off the schneid in a 40-30 lead. Terran has 11 points, and ODU with the basketball. Here comes Ronnie Williams. Send it left side to Sitlak. Sitlak working on Martise Kimbrough. Standing out by the volleyball line. Goes back to Ronnie Williams, left side. Williams coming around a De Leon screen. They'll switch it. Try to drive in on Singleton. Kick back to Sitlak. Little ball fake. Drive in the lane. Reverse pivot. Throw it up with the right hand. Off the backboard. Rebound. Kicked around. Still kicked around. Goes out of bounds. It'll be Oilers basketball. I think you take your chances with Adam Sitlak being out of control like that. So Oilers back-to-back stops here. A chance to build on this 10-point lead. Here comes Ricardo. Now he'll dribble right side. Handoff to Colic. Left side, or left point rather, to Terran. Terran ball fake, driving the lane, stop, throw it up, off the back iron, rebound, picked up by Sitlak. Here comes ODU again. Williams, right point, little stutter step, top the key to Variance, and then reverse it to Sitlak. He'll come around a Variance screen, dump down low to Hassan Variance, and throw it up, off the back iron, strong board. Well, I thought it was going to be a strong board, but it goes out of bounds off the hand of Variance. So be aware of the basketball. ODU came out strong here to start this half. 6-0 run, back-to-back three-point bombs. Oilers able to convert with a Terrence Sullivan jumper. We're here. That's how we're at this 10-point lead. Ball comes into the elbow to Terrence. Terrence will hand off to Elijah. Elijah driving the lane, kick out to Ricardo on the baseline. Ricardo looking to back down his man. He'll drive in, got his man up in the air, throw it up. Soft jumper, not able to get it to go down, nearly stolen away. But ODU picks it up, send it down to the baseline to Sitlak. Feed the post inside to Variance for an easy one. Just beat TST down the floor and back down to an 8-point lead. Boy, they're struggling on offense here. Martise driving the lane. A lot of contact. He lost it. Turn it over again. Charlie probably needs a timeout. Sam Hickey back to Sitlak. He'll launch it from downtown. That's short. Oilers need a board. Can't get it. Variance picks it up. Comes into De Leon. Turn face. Throw it up with the right hand. Missed it. Sullivan with the rebound. Oilers have numbers if they want it. Terran, top of the key. Picks up his dribble. Send it into TST. Up and under to Martise for an easy two. So Coach Ernst doesn't have to take that timeout. They stopped the bleeding with the easy bucket. Martise with 16 points. Williams will hand back to Sitlak. And Sitlak staying with it left side. Find Hickey, come around a screen. Thought about the step back. Now feed the post down the short corner. De Leon, turn, face, throw it up with the right hand. Missed it. Rebound by TST. Oilers with an opportunity. Ricardo working a break. He'll drive all the way in. Back to TST. Tyler throw it up with the right hand. Bucket and the foul. Tyler Stern-Tucker. And a nice job by Ricardo Smith to run the floor, to push it, really, and then TST to run the floor, and he's rewarded. That will bring us to a media timeout. 15:48 to go in the first and in the second half. Oilers lead at 42-32. This is Oilers basketball on 88.3 WLFC.
Oilers.
Biologistics is proud to support UFTV and the Findlay Media Network. Watch Oilers basketball live on uftv.findlay.edu.
Hey, look, it's those guys.
Get some drinks.
Are you good to drive?
I'm fine.
How many did you have?
I should be fine.
You should be?
Go and step out of the vehicle for me.
See ya, buddy. Good luck.
So turns out, buzz driving and drunk driving, they're the same thing. And it costs around $10,000. So not worth it.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID. UFTV is your university and community TV station.
Welcome back to Croy. Jason Granger here with you. Now the media timeout. Oilers with a 12-point lead as they fix the scoreboard. 44-32 is the lead, and Tyler Stern-Tucker, opportunity for the old-fashioned three-point play. So Oilers now have three players in double figures. Martise with 16, TST 13, and then Terrence Sullivan with 11. Tyler, toe the line, couple dribbles to the right hand, spin of the basketball, shots on its way, and he rattles it home. So 45-32 is the Oilers advantage. And the Oilers will fall back to their man-to-man. Ronnie Williams left side to Sitlak. Sitlak now will look over Collick, go right side to Sam Hickey. Feed the post inside of the block to their big man who is knocks it in. That is Hassan Variance who knocked that in. Nice looking jumper that time for the freshman. 11-point advantage for Findlay. Martise around the screen. Gets to the elbow, in some trouble, back out to Terran. Terran behind the back dribble, now looking to back down his man. He does, gets in the paint. Pretty move by Terrence Sullivan. Tip back up and good. He missed the first one, but got the offensive board and an easy one underneath. It's one of the best moves I've seen all year from Terran. Right side to Sam Hickey. Hickey will come around the screen. Then back out top, baseline drive by Casanova. Huge walk, no call. Variance will throw it up for two. Beautiful pass by Casanova. And now we get a steal as the Oilers just completely out of control. Sitlak got it blocked from the backside, but Ricardo just picked up his third foul. So the Oilers up 47-36 and sloppy with the basketball again. So Ricardo now probably had to come take a seat with his third foul. And Sitlak go to line. Before we get to that, I guess we're going to get a score check here. So 47-36, the score will remain. And Dan Evans upset with the score, and he's got a point. I mean, Oilers, the score got changed there at the timeout. I'm not sure why, but it is the correct score. Trey Smith will come into the ballgame. Ricardo Smith will check out. First foul shot for Sitlak was missed. And now we have some debris on the floor, so come over and pick that up. So opportunity coming here finally, I believe, for Adam Sitlak. Foul shot off the back iron. Strong board by TST, so nothing hurt on the turnover. And now Martise, right side. He'll come around the screen. Back top of the key. Pull-up jumper coming. Left it way short and out of bounds. Early shot by there by Martise. No passes in that possession. Kick out. Sam Hickey. Now he'll step inside the three-point line. His shot off the mark. Trey Smith with the rebound. Trey will send it ahead to Martise. Martise ahead to Terrence. Terrence looking about a three. Now a hand back. Top of the key, TST. Tyler, drive all the way in. Throw up the shot with the right hand. And we get bucket and the foul. Both officials looked at each other, and they looked out the sweet Mo Kincaid, and normally Mo is going to give that charge. So call did not come in. So now an opportunity for TST with the bucket and the foul for the old-fashioned three-point play. So foul shot coming for TST. Oilers up 13 off that make, and now we're getting some conversation with Mo Kincaid. So here comes the foul shot. Ball's in the air, and that one rattles home. So Oilers back up to that 14-point advantage, 50-36. Tyler Stern-Tucker with 17 points. See Aaron Overheiser, next dead ball. Send it right side to Sitlak, top the key to Casanova, reverse it over to Williams. Williams able to break the screen, driving the lane, over to Casanova. Shot go no. He'll kick it out to Sitlak. Three-point bomb is good. It's a really good ball movement. And Sitlak with a turnover. Picks it up. Trey Smith turned it over. Casanova, he'll drive in the lane. Kick out. Ronnie Williams from downtown. And that's a six-point possession. Oilers completely out of control with the basketball. Six-point possession for ODU. And the lead is eight at 50-42. Martise Kimbrough able to crowd the basketball, send it underneath to Trey. Trey then back to TST. He'll throw it up for two. So crazy contact going on right now. We are extremely physical, and then you foul it, and then you give that. Give me a break. Oiler lead should be 10. The bucket went in. It's 52-42. Tyler Stern-Tucker will take a seat. And it'll be ODU basketball with a 10-point lead for the Oilers. Williams, stutter step. He'll drive. Got away with a push. And we get an offensive foul. It's going to go on Michael Simon and a little hip check there. And we'll go back the other way. So maybe the official's going to try to step in, try to get control of this game because they've lost control. As things starting to get chippy here. Ball come into Trey Smith. Trey will walk it across the timeline. Go right side to Elijah Kolick. Top of the key, AO. Reverse it. Left side to Terran. Terran baseline drive. Thought about the step back. Now he'll drive in again. Up and under to Ariel. Bucket is good for Aaron Overheiser. And what an assist by Terran Sullivan. This lead back up to 10. 54-42. Make that 12. Hickey around his screen. Got away with another walk. Now he'll launch the three. Wide open. Terran left alone. He knocks it in. Sam Hickey's got 12. 54-45, 12:40 to go in the second half. Top of the key is Martise. Martise got his man up in the air, a little spin move, and throw it up. No good. And stolen away by Terran Sullivan, but out of bounds. And it'll stay here with ODU. So substitution, Cat Singleton will come into the ballgame, and Oilers got to keep their poise here as this has gotten completely out of control. ODU just 7 seconds to get it across the timeline. So Casanova to inbound. Ball come into Williams. Williams, cross-court pass to Hickey. Hickey Behind the back dribble, now reset. Send it down to Simon on the baseline. He'll use his dribble, dribble out of pressure, and he'll reset with Ronnie Williams. Williams around the screen. They'll go under it. Ball comes down low to Simon. Simon got away with a walk, and he forgot the basketball. Went with a spin move that time, left something on the floor. It was the basketball and a turnover, and Oilers now with an opportunity to get this back up to double digits. So there's a switch point guard responsibility here. Martise will take it across the timeline. Go left point to Taren. Taren turned face on Casanova. Now hand back to Tease, who thought about the three. Martise, step back three coming. Not there. Long rebound still on the floor. Martise able to pick it up. Oilers got numbers. Need to send it in, and they do, but they throw it off the foot that time of Aaron Oberheiser, and back we go the other way. Ronnie Williams throw it up. Spin move is good. Findlay's completely out of control right now. Martise, right side, needs some help. Gets it top of the key to Taren. Taren, nobody covers him. He's going to go ahead and launch a shot. That's way off the mark. The Oilers are not running any offense at all, and this has turned into an open gym. Hickey back the other way. He'll throw it up. Bucket's good, and Charlie needs a timeout. 54-49, and before Charlie can take a timeout, Dan Evans takes a timeout. So we'll go ahead and take it. 11:49 to go in this one. Oilers completely out of control, but still lead by five. This is Oilers basketball, 88.3 WLFC.
I'm Jenny Garth, and as a mother of three, I know kids worry about a lot of things. Getting enough food to eat shouldn't be one of them. But here in America, that is a real worry for one in five children. This is unacceptable, and something Feeding America is working to solve. Through a nationwide network of food banks, Feeding America serves virtually every community in the United States, including yours. See how you can help your community. Visit feedingamerica.org. Together, we can solve hunger. Together, we're Feeding America.
UFTV is your university and community TV station. Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay. 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID.
This is Martise Kimbrough. You're listening to Oilers Basketball on 88.3.
Welcome back to Croy. Jason Granger here with you. And Oilers had a 14-point lead. It's now down to 5. 54-49 is the score. Oilers have turned it over 10 times here, a lot of those in the second half. So High Dominican has outscored the Oilers by 9 here in this second quarter, 25-16. That's why we had this 5-point game. So it'll be Oilers basketball. And certainly missed opportunities with this pressure. Oilers have had opportunities, but haven't been able to convert. Tyler Stern-Tucker, right point with the basketball. Now top of the key to Aaron. Oberheiser hold it, go left point to Trey Smith. Send it inside to TST. They clear it out for him. Picks up his dribble, needs some help. Back out to Trey. Thought about the three. Feed it inside to Tyler again. Turn face, throw up the shot. Off the mark. Baseline jumper, no good. And another rebound to ODU. Williams top of the key. Casanova nearly lost it. Now Casanova the drive. He's out of control. Stolen away by Trey Smith. Oilers with an opportunity. Trey's got to be careful here. Right side to Singleton. Singleton, the ball fake, driving the lane. Throw up the floater, missed it. Nearly airballed it there, and Sitlak with the rebound. Oilers have every opportunity to have complete control of this game and just have not done it. Can't throw it in the ocean. Williams wide open from downtown and left it short. Oberheiser with the rebound. See if Findlay can get a bucket. Back-to-back stops on the defensive end. Smith around an Oberheiser screen. We'll see Terrence Sullivan, next dead ball. Sends it over to Martise, left point. Now top of the key to TST, back to Martise. Martise, step back, jumper on the way, got it, just inside the three-point line. 56-49, stops the bleeding there for the Oilers. Simon, top of the key, hand back to Sitlak. Sitlak defended by Oberheiser, now they go inside. Simon against Cat. Boy, a lot of contact, and turned it over. Dribbled it right off his knee that time, and we'll have some substitutions. So Elijah Kyle will come back in. Before we get to that, we'll get a media timeout. So 9:49 to go in the ball game. Oilers lead at 56-49. This is Findlay basketball on 88.3 WLC.
When I was six, my mom had a stroke.
I'm Paul George. Learn the signs of a stroke fast.
F, face drooping. A, arm weakness. S, speech difficulty. T, time to call 911. Spot a stroke fast.
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
Or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it. It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Biologistics is proud to support UFTV and the Findlay Media Network. Watch Oiler basketball live on uftv.findlay.edu.
UFTV is your university and community TV station.
Welcome back to Croy. Jason Granger here with you. Oilers off the turnovers, back-to-back turnovers by ODU, and now got that lead back up to 7. It's been as large as 14 in this one. Some scores from around the Gulliac Grand Valley with a 28-16 lead over Wayne State. Walsh with a 43-33 lead over Hillsdale. That's at Hillsdale. So back to live action. Ricardo Smith in the game. Left side to Martiz Kimbrough. Took it to go inside to Rick, and they do. Ricardo, turn, throw it up the right hand. Got it blocked. Put back. No good, but he's fouled. And Ricardo will go to line for two, and that will be the third foul on Hassan Variance. So big possession there. You get two foul shots coming, and Variance picks up his third. So decision time for Dan Evans. So Rick, a couple opportunities here. Just 2 points for Ricardo. And his left hand taped up quite a bit there. First foul shot is nipping in. So De Leon will come back into the ball game. Variance will take a seat. Second one coming for Rick. Foul shot on and way, and that's in and out. Rebound goes to the Panthers. Ronnie Williams running the point most of the second half. Send it left side to De Leon. Oilers line up in some zone. Inside to De Leon. Cross court pass to Williams. Step back three. No, we'll pass it out to Hickey. Hickey will launch it from way downtown. It's good. Guy can shoot. And we're back down to a 5-point lead. 57-52. Top of the key with Tarrant. He'll hand off to Martiz. Got it stripped away. Martiz has it now at the top. He'll come around the screen, try to split it, go back to TST. Tyler thought about it, and then feed the post inside to Ricardo Smith. Ricardo, cross-court pass to Martiz. Fancy dribbling, 10 on the shot clock. Not a lot of movement from the Oilers here tonight. Martiz will drive all the way in, throw up the shot, left hand, can't get it, tip up, no good, and rebound to the Panthers. Williams back the other way. Back out to Hickey. He's wide open again, and he missed that one short. Rebound comes to Ricardo Smith. Oilers got away with one there. Ricardo, crossover, driving the lane, kick out to no one, but then corralled by TSD. Cross-court pass to Collett. Elijah back to the top of the key to TSD. Tyler, fancy dribbling, driving the lane, needs some help, kick out to Sullivan. Tarrant, looking over the defense, 12 on the shot clock. Feed the post inside to TSD. Dump down underneath to Collett, and he got hammered. Push from the backside by Sitlak. Second foul on Adam Sitlak, fifth team foul on the Panthers. So we'll reset the shot clock. Shamir Wall will come into the game. Sam Hickey will come out. No, Hickey will stay. Williams will come out. So we're the basketball underneath their own 10. Ball come all the way up top to Taren. Left point now, and then inside to Rick. Rick will throw it up. Easy one for two. Wall tried to take the charge. No call on this one. You got to draw blood before you're going to get a foul. 59-52. Wall picked up by TST. Reversed it over to Sitlak. Come around his screen. Back top of the key. Right side to Wall. Wall wants a screen. Gets it. Picked up his dribble. Dumped down underneath Consanova. Wide open. Easy one is good. High ball screens have been a problem for the Oilers all game long. 59-54. Oilers out in front. Elijah sent it down the baseline. Inside to TST. His layup is good. So back-to-back easy ones by both teams. Findlay lead back out in front by 7. Back we go the other way. Sam Hickey thought about the 3, almost threw it away. Wall picks it up. Come around a screen. Dump down low inside to Casanova. He'll go up against, well, he got away with Wall. Should be 3 and a key. No call. Wall now with the drive. He'll throw it up. Scoop to the hoop style. No good, but unfortunately, Sullivan picks up the foul. And we get Hickey and Sullivan with a little extracurriculars there. Cooler heads prevail. And that should bring us to a media timeout. So 7:21 to go in this one. Oilers 61, ODU 54. This is Findlay Basketball on 88.3 WLFC.
This is the story of a boy who is very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where nothing could get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. It made him feel uncomfortable. One day, he found out he had something called autism. His family got him help. And slowly, he learned how to live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
Or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it. It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
An impressive basketball team, and so far this year, by far the most physical team that I've seen this season, and certainly they play with a chip on their shoulder. Oilers, maybe, I thought we missed Alex White on Thursday and Austin Garner, both of them, and certainly missing both of them today. Just an 8-man rotation, really more like a 7-man rotation for Charlie Ernst, and you hope fatigue isn't a problem. So Shamir Wah will be at the line to shoot 2. First foul shot coming for Wah, and that's way short off the front iron. Second foul shot coming for Wah, lefty. Junior from Northland High School. That one's in and out. And Tyler Stern Tucker just picked up his 9th rebound. Oilers will send it ahead. Sullivan, then TST at the top. Left side, Ricardo Smith. Go inside to Sullivan. Taren can go to work. He does. Turn, throw it up with the right hand. Got it. How about that move? A couple pivots in the lane, and Weather's now up by 9. Back we go the other way. Wall fakes out everybody, driving the lane. Scoop to the hoop, no good. Ricardo Smith with the rebound. Oilers want to run again. Ricardo across the timeline, and he turned it over. Oilers just cannot help themselves, and Sitlak misses the jam. So back we go the other way. Tyler Stern Tucker, he'll drive in. Scoop to the hoop, no good. Casanova with the rebound, and this one's thrown away right over to me. So the Oilers will maintain possessions. You got both head coaches frustrated, and these officials, to be quite honest, have not been any good both ways. Contact everywhere. No call either side. Toughest team's going to win this one today. So Martise will inbound. Ball come in to Ricardo Smith. Oilers dodge a big bullet off the Sitlak. And finally, we get Adam Sitlak with the foul. It took a day and a half to get one. And Sitlak picks up his 3rd foul. So now it'll be sideline out of bounds again. 6th foul on ODU. Next one to put the Oilers in the bonus. Ball comes all the way in the backcourt to Taren Sullivan. And Taren will throw it across the timeline to Martise Kimbrough. Martise drill right side. Go to Ricardo. Now top of the key, TST. Left side, Taren. Taren top of the key, Elijah. Elijah with the drive. A lot of contact again, and he got a shot block. Blocked away by Sam Hickey. Hickey picks it up. ODU wants to run. Got it stolen away. Send it ahead. Collin gets it. Ahead to Sullivan. Sullivan will go up with the right hand. Bucket in the foul for Taren Sullivan. And how do you like some of that? Little look as well from Taren. And we get referee Ed Phillips trying to tell Taren to settle down. How about we tell Casanova to settle down? And what an athletic move as Sitlak picks up his 4th foul, and I imagine he'll have to take a seat. So tensions flaring here in Croy. Spilling over here to press row as well. Trey Smith will check in if Tarrant can make this foul shot. He does. So Weathers up 66-54. Sitlack going to remain in the ball game. Actually, they changed the foul. So Ricardo Smith will come out. So Ronnie Williams taking across the timeline. 6:05 to go in the second half. Back to Sam Hickey. Hickey thought about going underneath. Casanova, then right side Williams. Williams wide open from downtown. Off the back iron. Orioles need a board. Elijah Kolick able to corral it. Elijah will send it ahead to Trey Smith, who checked in. Left side, Elijah. Steps in. Oh, thought about stepping into the three. Whistle and a foul. And foul's going to be with Sam Hickey. And that'll send Elijah to the line. Elijah just 2 points here today. Now an opportunity at the line for one plus the bonus. So Elijah the junior from Fort Recovery. Foul shot on its way. In and out. Not Elijah's day. So back we go the other way. Here's Ronnie Williams. He'll come around the screen. Now driving the lane. Throw up a running eight-hander. That's not there. Sullivan picks up the rebound, and he's going to lead the break. Tarrant threw it to no one in particular. Tossed it out of bounds and turned it over. Just be under control. Now, that's a situation there where Tarrant just takes it all the way to the 10. He's got an easy one. Elijah hasn't been able to throw it in the ocean tonight, and he was trying to get it out to Elijah Kolick. So 5:33 to go in this one. Weathers up by 12. De Leon will try to check it in and does to Sam Hickey. Hickey on the run down the right side of the floor. And they'll hand back to Williams. Williams now will hand back to Sitlack. Sitlack back top of the key, defended by Martise. Goes left side to Williams. He's open for three, and that's good. Can't give him that many opportunities. He knocks it in, lead down to 9, 66-57. Closing in on 5 minutes to go here in the ballgame. Crossover dribble by Tarrant in the lane. Right-handed spin move up and in. Tarrant Sullivan. And the big man's fired up here. Tarrant's got 20. Williams now hand back to Sitlack. Sitlack looking over the defense. Whistle and a foul. Foul's going to go on, I believe, on Trey Smith. Wait and see here. Yep, go on Trey. He traced third foul, fourth team foul on the Oilers. Variance will check back in. Trey Smith will take a seat. Ricardo Smith will come in for him. So Ronnie Williams to inbound for ODU. Ball comes into Casanova. Top of the key, Hickey. Hickey defended by Smith, stolen away and picked up by Martise, and Oilers will hold. Take it across the timeline. Martise looking to start the offense. Gets into Elijah. Elijah, left-handed layup is good. Came around on the curls that time. Got in the lane, made it happen. 70-57. Oilers out in front. Williams, left side to Sitlack. Sitlack wanted to go to Sam Hickey, not there. Right side to Williams. Now he'll go ahead and launch the three, and that's good. Ronnie Williams heating up here for ODU. Lead down to 10. And Dan Evans is on the court. And what are you going to do? No technical foul at all. Crazy. TST, left side, got away with a walk. Driving the lane, throw it up the left hand, can't get it. Blocked away by Variance, and the Oilers need to get back here. Variance needs some help, finds Williams. Oilers a 10-point lead, closing on 4 minutes to go in the ballgame. Top of the key with it, and Williams picks up the foul on TST. So an even 4 minutes to go in this one. And Danny Evans still up in the ear of referee John Floyd. And John Floyd, to be quite honest, did him a favor. Dan Evans, and I'm not exaggerating, was all the way out in the key during a live play trying to get a timeout, and nothing happened. So Sitlack, right point, holding the basketball, goes to Variance at the top. Variance hand back to Ronnie Williams. Williams thought about that three. Now dumped down underneath. Whistle, and what do we get? A charge. Elijah Kolick steps in, takes the charge. Fourth foul on Variance. Dan Evans calling for a timeout. Got news for you, Dan. You don't have to call it. It's a media timeout. 3:44 to go in this one. Oilers lead it 70-60. This is Oilers basketball on UFTV and 88.3 WLC.
It takes less than 1 minute to find out if you may have prediabetes. You can do it here. But you probably won't. You're busy. Kids, work. Show coming back in 48 seconds. So let's do this now. Hold up one finger if you're a man. Women, zero. Three more fingers if you're over 60. Two over 50. One over 40. If you're not sure, keep in mind you're sitting on a couch right now. So one more finger if you're not very active. One finger if yes, zero if no. One yes, zero no. Next, find the body type that looks most like you and hold up that many fingers while I look around awkwardly. And that's it. If you're holding up five fingers or more, you probably have prediabetes. Sorry to be so blunt, but hey, you're busy. Just go to the site.
UFTV is your university and community TV station.
LFC.
Welcome back to Croy. Jason Granger here with you. Oilers with a 70-60 lead. Lead's been as big as 14. It's been as small as 5 here in the second half. Tyler Stern-Tucker has 21. Terrence Sullivan with 20. And Martise with 18. It's been the big three for the Oilers. Oilers still struggling to shoot the basketball from three. Have yet to make a three-point jumper here in the second half. 0-3 from downtown here. Give a lot of credit to ODU, a very feisty team, you might say. And it's been called perfectly for the way they want to play, as it's been a very physical ball game. So out of the timeout, it'll be Oiler possession, and now really need to take care of the basketball. Good touches, and get the ball down the post. 19 fouls for ODU. It's a double bonus time here for the Oilers. So Oilers to get things started here with Martise Kimbrough. Martise to take it across the timeline. Go right point to TST. Tyler picked up his dribble, needs some help. Send it over to Colic. Colic, double team comes, whistle, and an offensive foul. Foul's going to go against TST. Be his third foul, fifth or sixth team foul. So an empty possession there for the Oilers, and only ran off about 10 seconds off the clock. So back we come with Ronnie Williams. Right point, top to Kitty Casanova, or to De Leon. De Leon goes back to Williams. He gets free. Three-point jumper is left short. Oilers need a rebound. And they're going to call a foul, offensive foul, on Ricardo Smith. And we should be shooting foul shots. So Ricardo just picked up his fifth foul. And not sure what the conversation is here, but I had Ricardo with three fouls. Yeah, it's just Ricardo's fourth foul. And now we're going to go to the monitor. And I'm not sure what we're looking at here with the monitor. And we'll come out of it. So not what you wanted to have happen if you're the Oilers. Now that media timeout, you get an empty possession and a turnover, and now Sam Hickey at the line, outstanding foul shooter for one plus the bonus.
Big rebound, Sterny, big rebound.
So Hickey to the line. Foul shot on the way, and that's off the back iron. And Terrence Sullivan skies to grab the board. Ricardo Smith with it. And now we'll go ahead and get a second opportunity here. Across the timeline, come around the screen, cut off, top of the key, TST, right side. To Colic, dumped down inside to Tyler, and he got it swatted away. Stripped away that time by Ronnie Williams, ahead to Hickey. Hickey with the baseline drive, his layup up and good. They are so good at running the ball down the floor. You miss one on one end, and it comes right back at you the other way. Oilers need to get a touch on the block and get fouled, go to the line. Hand back to Martise. Martise looking over the defense, top of the key to Ricardo Smith. Rick nearly got it stolen away, and he turned it over. Ball's going to come back the other way, and Oilers can't help themselves. 2:35 to go in the ball game, and another turnover. So right now, a three-possession game. ODU can get it down to a two-possession game with a field goal here. Boy, this is really struggling against the ball pressure of ODU. Ball comes into De Leon, top of the key, Williams. Williams, long range bomb is good. 5-point game. 70-65. Send it ahead to Collin. And Charlie Ernst wants the timeout. We'll take it. 2:19 to go in this one. Oilers up 5, 70-65. This is Oilers basketball on 88.3 WLFC.
Underwriting provided by Heavenly Pizza, 1404 North Main Street, Findlay, 419-423-7494. UF students get 10% off with ID.
Biologistics is proud to support UFTV and the Findlay Media Network. Watch Oiler basketball live on uftv.findlay.edu.
UFTV is your university and community TV station.
You're listening to 88.3.
Welcome back to Croy. Jason Granger here with you. It's an 8-0 run by Ohio Dominican. And just a 5-point lead now for Findlay at 70-65. The Oilers have not scored in the last 2 minutes. And really, it's double bonus time for Findlay if you just get it inside and go to the line. So Ricardo Smith, top of the key. Send it right side, TST, then back to Taren, and then over to Rick. Top of the key, Tease. They'll go ahead and clear it out for him. Now send it over to Tyler Stern-Tucker. Tyler, put it on the floor with right hand. Step back, jumper from the elbow. Need it. Can't get it. Offensive rebound. No. Defensive rebound. Picked up by ODU. Good defensive possession for the Panthers. Ronnie Williams rush it up. Sam Hickey, he'll launch it from downtown. That's way short, and that'll go out of bounds off the hand of Casanova, or actually De Leon, and so the Oilers will be Oilers possession. A lot of empty possessions here for the Oilers. And need to get one here. Martise now handle the point guard duties and see if we get a touch on the block. Been calling for it. Hadn't happened. Ricardo, top of the key. Wants a screen. Gets it from TST. He'll drive in the lane. Cross-court bath to Pig. Right side to Taren. Taren, hesitation. Into the lane. Reverse pivot. Kick out to Elijah. 10 on the shot clock. Elijah will come around the screen. Needs to go back to Taren and does. Taren, baseline drive. He'll go ahead and flip it up. Tip it up. Can't get it. Tip back, no good. Ball on the floor. Still on the floor and picked up by ODU. He'll send it ahead to Hickey. Sam Hickey right side. Now a minute 15 to go in this one. Williams dumped down low inside. De Leon wide open. Nobody picked him up, and it's a three-point game. Oilers have gone nearly 3 minutes without a bucket. 1 minute to go in the contest. This is where Carter needs to get across the timeline, and he does. Carter. Double team comes, sent it to TST. Tyler Stern-Tucker can't get the layup to go, and he's knocked out of bounds. He knocked his shoulder out, and it's back the other way. Whistle and a timeout as Tyler Stern-Tucker is injured as his shoulder has been knocked out of place. And again, Dan Evans is beside himself, and so that will be an injury timeout. So we'll see Kat Single to check in. If the injury bug hasn't been enough for the Oilers this year, it's another one happening. So we'll see if it's something if Tyler can get it popped back into place or not. So they'll bring Kat Singleton in to the ball game. You know, it's amazing. You get your shoulder knocked down, and it's no call. Oilers need to stop here. 44 seconds to go in the game. Oilers with a three-point lead. So we'll get things started. Sitlack, send it into Williams. Got to guard the three-point line. Williams come around the screen. They'll switch it. Now go right side to Sitlack. He'll launch the three, and that's short. Oilers need a board. It hit off the score table or the shot clock, and so it'll be Findlay possession. 33 seconds to go in this one. So we'll have full court pressure by ODU. Again, Oilers have not scored since the four-minute mark. Had a 13-point lead. Oilers, well, Dan Evans will take a timeout and give the Oilers an opportunity to talk about it. So Tyler Stern-Tucker, we'll keep it here. Tyler Stern-Tucker is okay. He's back off the training table and looks to be fine. So let's recap where we're at. With 3 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the ball game, the Oilers had a 70-57 lead. Since then, it's been a 10-0 run by ODU. Oilers have not been able to make a field goal nor get to the foul line and turn it over two or three times to get themselves in this predicament. Good news is it's Oilers basketball underneath their, underneath ODU's 10. 33 seconds to go in this one. You got to be strong with the basketball. Imagine right now you want to get the ball in to either Elijah or Martise and be strong with it. Get it across the timeline, get fouled, go to the line. See how Dan Evans tries to play it here. My guess would be he would foul right away. So Cat Singleton will inbound. Ball come down the sideline to Elijah and then back to Martise. Martise lost it and turned it over. Just lost the basketball. And that's exactly how this game has been going all day long. Oilers can't help themselves at all this game. And that was just a simple pass back to Martise. And he just couldn't handle the pass. It was a good pass from Elijah. So now we're under 30 seconds to go in the game. And the ball will come back to Ronnie Williams. Williams, top the key. He'll drive all the way in. Got it stripped away and picked up by Cat. Cat will stand and hold the ball, and he's fouled. So you're not going to see many videos either way from either side on how to handle late-game situations. Both teams have turned it over like it's their job in this game, and we'll see if the Oilers now can go to the line and make a couple foul shots. So Cat will have two opportunities here. Need to get at least one here. Cat yet to score in this ball game. First foul shot is hard off the back iron. Second one coming for Singleton. Foul shot on its way. Also off the back iron. And rebound goes to ODU. So Singleton misses both of them. Williams coming across the timeline, called timeout. So 19 seconds to go in the ball game. Dan Evans will take a timeout. We'll take it. This is Oilers basketball on 88.3 WLC.
Keats.
This is the story of a boy who was very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where nothing could get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. It made him feel uncomfortable. One day, he found out he had something called autism. His family got him help. And slowly, he learned how to live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
Welcome back to Croy. Jason Granger here with you. And 19 seconds on the clock. Oilers up by three, 70-67. Both teams have had opportunities. Oilers had the biggest opportunity. This is a 13-point game with just under 4 minutes to play, and Oilers haven't scored. ODU's on a 10-0 run to get it within three. Cat Singleton is at the line with two foul shots, missed them both. So now it's Ohio Dominican basketball with 19 on the game clock. So we'll see if the Oilers can get a stop. Got to defend the three-point line. So Sitlak will inbound. Ball come all the way in the backcourt. Nearly stolen away by Ricardo Smith, and he fouls Ronnie Williams. And that's it for Ricardo. And it kind of shows how the game's gone. Absolutely do not want to foul there. And they do. And now Ronnie Williams will go to the foul line to shoot one plus the bonus. Trey Smith will check into the game. So Trey will come in. Now, I don't doubt that the Oilers might have wanted to foul there, but you would want to foul with under 3 seconds left. So the Oilers have got extremely tight here in this end of the game scenario. Ronnie Smith, or Ronnie Williams, rather, will shoot the foul shot. Foul shot on the way, and it's good. Ronnie Williams has 18 points here today. Sam Hickey, 19 for ODU. Second opportunity coming for Williams. And that's also good. So can the Oilers be strong with the basketball and make some foul shots? Find out. Ball comes into Martise. Got to get across the timeline. And we get a foul. So Martise, 94% foul shooter. Now we'll go to the line. And he'll have two shots at it. 13.5 seconds to go in the game. And we'll have to go back through it. But the Oilers, by my count, have turned the ball over six times in this last 4 minutes. We've also missed two foul shots that really could have put the ball game away. So first foul shot for Martise. A couple dribbles of the basketball. Foul shot is good. So now it's a two-point game. Second one coming for Martise Kimbrough. And we'll see if Martise can knock it in here. Second one coming from Tease. That one's good. And we get a timeout, Charlie Ernst. 30-second timeout, so let's keep it here. Oilers with a three-point advantage, 22-69, and or I'm sorry, 72-69. And talking strategy now, and Oilers have been in this situation before this season. And they're in this situation up at Ferris State. Three-point lead and elected to foul, and I imagine that's what Charlie Ernst will do. And the key here is that you want to defend the three-point line early in the shot clock, get them to have to toss it back out with five, and then that's when you go ahead and foul with hopefully under 3 seconds. So see if the Oilers are able to execute here down the stretch. So out of the timeout, Trey Smith, Kat Singleton, Martise Kimbrough, Elijah Collick, and Terrence Sullivan are your five on the floor. TST had to go out with an injury. He's over there smiling. I think he's okay. Oilers have been hit hard by the injury bug all year long. Full court pressure by Findlay. Williams trying to get it in and does. Gets it into Ronnie Williams, and he'll take it across the timeline with 10 seconds. Williams come around the screen. Baseline drive, drive all the way in. Kick out. Sam Hickey from downtown missed it. Ball's up in the air. Kick out. Simon, he'll launch it from downtown. That's short, and that'll be the ball game. Oilers win it in dramatic fashion. Didn't have to be this way, but it still counts all the same. Oilers win it. 72-69 over High Dominican. Don't go anywhere. We'll have the post game coming up next. It's Oilers basketball on 88.3 WLC.
Kirk Cairo.